All right, let's talk dynamic warm-ups. Before you do anything, you should always spend 10 to 15 minutes getting warmed up on any given day, any activity, any routine. All right, things you can do. You start some monster walks, all right? And again, remember, this does not take, you don't need to have a lot of space. You can do this in a tight area. As you know from doing warm-ups for hockey games and whatnot, you've done this in hallways, in the locker room, or the back of a rink. So something you can easily do in your basement, your room, wherever you got some space, okay? So again, let's talk about monster walks. Keep your legs straight, bring it all the way up. We're gonna take our opposite hand, touch our opposite toe, and we're just gonna take some walks with it as we go along, all right? That's a great warm-up. That'll get your hamstrings going, fire off your glutes, and down your calf muscles a bit, all right? We can take that and change it up a little bit, and we'll add a little twist to it. So when I bring my leg up, I'm just gonna kind of rotate, all right, a little up, a little rotation, a little up, a little rotation, up, a little rotation. Same idea, keep your leg under control, don't flail, all right? Again, bring it up nice and straight, a little rotation, we're still gonna reach out and touch our toes, all right? Now we're just adding in some range of motion in there, help get your hips unlocked, okay? So just as a hockey player, it's really important. What else can we do? Let's talk about our feet and things. All right, remember, how we get power, we gotta push off our feet and use our edges to be good skaters. So we wanna get our ankles unlocked, right? Just stand on your tippy toes, and you can walk sideways, all right? You can go back and forth, sideways, and you can turn around, you can do a front, all right, you go backwards. And to give you an idea, spread yourself out. You know, you want to go from a good chunk of distance. So keep going, keep going. All right, the idea here is that we want to put motion and movement into our warm-up here. So this way we're actually having to make our body do some work to get warmed up, all right? So that's really great to get your ankles. And then obviously your toes to your heels. All right, stay on your heels and just walk back and forth sideways and front and back. Okay, really great to get your ankles unlocked. You can always do around the world in your ankles, just roll them, right? Whichever way, clockwise, counterclockwise. Up and down, left and right, clockwise again, all right? Again, some good mobility right there for your ankles. You can also do, all right? So about hips, some good things for hips. A little lunge, throw a twist in, help get the hip complex well unlocked, all right? Helps unlock your low back muscles, right? Your QL, which connects from your spine to your hip. That's what allows all this sideways movement. All right, it's really important to have that unlocked. So that's why we'll add in that little bit of twist, especially because as hockey players, we're moving in a million different ways. So we don't want to be stagnant in our dynamic warm-up. We want to be adding some different motions and movement into it. All right? The only way you can do that forwards, but you can do it backwards and just simple lunges. You can go backwards. All right? Again, get your body accustomed to going up and down. All right? Get your hips ready and unlocked for that skating position. Some other things we can do would be some scoops. Stretch your leg out, put your heel on the ground, keep your toes up, or it's good. Scoop down, all right? Heel planted, toe up, leg straight, come down, touch your toes practically, all right? And what we're gonna feel there is you'll feel from your glutes here, all the way in the back, your hamstring down into your calf muscle, right? And just take a little walk with it each time. Again, remember, keep good form, that's important here, all right? There's always another great drill, all right? You've got some high knees, all right? Remember, focus on pushing off your toes, staying under control, all right, when you see guys just like flailing around, that's not smart. Be under control with everything that you do, okay? be under control. Up, down, up, down. Use your arms, power them through. Again, just like skating, we want to get our arms active and ready for that type of motion. All right? And we've got the opposite, which is going to be butt kicks. Again, same thing, so butt kicks. We're going to get your quads here unlocked. All right? Get that heel all the way up here into your glutes. All right? Don't be afraid to use your arms. Again, under control, staying on your toes at all times. All right? Then, let's talk about some side lunges. We'll get low, and we're going to rock back and forth. When I go back and forth, I'm getting my leg fully extended. The other leg fully extended, I'm going to sink down in my hips, and then I'll switch. All right? Again, practicing on the fact that we want to keep our upper torso nice and tall, just like when we skate. So again, focus on keeping your upper torso nice and tall, even when you do an exercise or a warm-up like this, okay? Sink through the hips and you just rotate. All right? Down. And pull one to the other. Boom. Boom. All right? Some other great ones I really like would be hip hinges. All right? Hip hinges are great. Up and over. Up and over, okay? Take your two hands, one hand on the inside of your knee, one hand on the out. Guide your knee through the range of motion. You should guide your knee through that range of motion, okay? It's important because you want to feel that muscle getting unlocked through the hip, okay? So don't just come up and flail around. I don't like it when I see that because that means you're not doing it under control. Up and guide it. Force the muscle through its range of motion in a slow and steady pace. Again, this way you're actually working it, okay? What else can we talk about? Inchworms, right? Get down, right? Legs straight, keep them straight, and just crawl right up to your hands as close as you can. Then we'll step out again. Let's try to stay out of this mud. All right, down, keep legs straight, crawl up. Stay on your tippy toes. Again, you'll feel that from your calf muscles up to your hamstrings into your glutes. Great exercise there. All right.